Hello everyone, and welcome once again to Let's Play Skyrim. Recall that last time, when we left off, I had just entered Forebear's holdout with the goal to rescue a moth priest who I know has been captured by a vampire named Malchus. I see a death hound down there. Color me pleasantly surprised that the kill cam managed not to fuck up the shot. That's kind of a rarity. I see another death hound. That'll be my next target. There's not much to this place, incidentally. It's very, very small. Really just this one little structure here. Not even anything in the water, if I remember right. Nonetheless, let's track alongside it. Keep an eye on the water, just in case. Oh, crud. Well, I didn't mean to do that. I assure you. All's well that ends well. We need to explore this little area on this side anyway, I suppose. And there we go. It's explored. Let's head back over here. Anything? Anything? Looks like a thrall. A few mushrooms and other plants, but really nothing of substance. This appears to be the intended way in. So let me just sweep back along this wall, make sure I didn't miss anything. Got another entrance there. Oh, balls, really? Really? Now that's a glitch I am really getting fed up with. Where it doesn't give me a full power shot for some reason, even though I totally drew all the way back. Annoying. Annoying. Anyway. Let's head in here now. I see somebody up there. Fuck! How did that miss? I don't know. Here's the first one I shot. Two ways up. So, sounds like we didn't quite get here in time. Moth Priest just caved and acknowledged the vampire as his master. That can't be good. Deactivate the magic barrier. OK. Okay, let's try this again. Waystone focus. Looks like one of the Imperial Guards was dead there, and they tried to raise him. Didn't do much. Let's sweep along this wall right quick. I actually think we've already killed everything. Let me just check over here. Man, I felt like it was going to reward my exploration. I thought I remembered a chest. Oh well. There's a boss chest in here. That's always nice. Not much in it, but I suppose that's okay. Several ways up to this wall. Try and check everything out before I leave. Not that there's really much else to find. So let's quick save and deactivate the barrier. Activate Waystone Source. Completed. Deactivate the magic barrier. Defeat the enthralled moth priest. I'm sure I heard something. Harkin's agents have captured the moth priest. I have tracked them to Forebear's holdout, but the vampires have enthralled the moth priest, and I will have to confront him in order to break their hold. Completed. Defeat the enthralled moth priest. Speak to the moth priest. Harkon's agents captured the moth priest and enthralled him, but I was able to break their hold on his mind.
I could see through my eyes, but I could not control my actions. Thank you for breaking that foul vampire's hold over me. You arrived just in time. I think those vampires were getting hungry. Thank the divines for you.
Are you all right?
I'm quite all right, thanks to you. Dexian Evicus is my name. I'm a moth priest of the White Gold Tower. These vampires claimed they had some purpose in store for me, but they wouldn't say what. Probably hoping to ransom me, the fools.
I know why they needed you, because we need you for the same purpose.
You do? All right. Enough mystery.
We're called the Dawn Guard, and we need you to read an Elder Scroll.
You have an Elder Scroll? Remarkable. If my knowledge of history serves me, I recall that the Dawn Guard was an ancient order of vampire hunters. I will be happy to assist you with your Elder Scroll. Just tell me where I need to go.
You can find us at Fort Dawn Guard, near Stendar's Beacon.
Very well. I'll hurry on my way there before more of those vampires turn up.
Completed. Rescue the Moth Priest. Completed. Speak to the Moth Priest. Report your success to Isran. I rescued the Moth Priest from his vampire captors and asked him to meet me at Fort Dawnguard. I must return to Isran and tell him of our success. Alright. And I offloaded fairly recently, but we did fight a dragon on our way over here, so probably will behoove me to offload again on my way back to Fort Dawnguard. These dragon parts are heavy. Oh yeah. I should also make sure I've exhausted dialogue with Dexion. That was a silly thing to forget. The fuck is he, anyway? There he is. Of course. Up. Can we get up here? Of course not. There we go. Gee willikers. Come on. There we go.
I owe you a debt for the timely rescue.
What do moth priests do exactly?
It is our sacred duty to study the Elder Scrolls. We read these ancient scrolls of prophecy in order to divine the future, and we use that knowledge to aid the Emperor. Sometimes, we venture out into the world in search of more scrolls for our library at the White Gold Tower. That is the very purpose that first brought me to Skyrim.
The White Gold Tower?
It is the great spire at the heart of the Imperial City, among the tallest towers in all of Tamriel. The lower floors are home to the Imperial Council, and the Order of Moth Priests occupies the middle floors. The tower suffered damage in the recent war with the Altmeri Dominion, and is not what it once was. I hope one day to see it restored to its former glory.
What do you know about the Elder Scrolls?
Not as much as I would like. Even after spending decades of my life in study of the Elder Scrolls, they remain a great mystery to me. It's true for most of my brothers in the Order as well. We don't really know where the scrolls came from or who wrote them. What we do know is that some are born with the special gift to read the Elder Scrolls. These chosen few can divine events of the past and future within the scrolls, though in time, it drives us to blindness. I'm afraid there's not much more to tell. Even today, the Elder Scrolls remain a great enigma.
All right.
This is all more exciting than used to.
Excuse me. Now we'll head out, like I was mentioning. First, a quick offload at Windstead.
Trust you're not planning any trouble. What can I do for you, friend?
You're back! Wanna play a game?
Sure!
What do you want to play?
Let's play hide and seek.
Okay. You stand right there and count to 10. No peeking. Ready? Go!
Let's just drop stuff off. I think I found it. Any smeltables, I think it's just the dragon parts, honestly. Yep, there we go. All's well. So let's head to Fort Dawnguard. Alrighty. Off to Fort Dawnguard. Let's have a chat with Isran.
I'm impressed you could find a moth priest so quickly.
Does he have the scroll? Is everything ready?
For the reading? Yeah. Just let the old man know when you're ready.
Completed. Report your success to Isran. Speak to the moth priest. With the moth priest safely back at Fort Dawnguard, he can now read Serana's Elder Scroll and learn more about the prophecy that Harkon is hoping to use to gain power over the sun.
What can I do for you? My trip to Skyrim has become quite the adventure. Ah, hello there. What can I do for you?
Glad you made it here safely, Dexian.
Ah, my rescuer. It's good to see you again.
Have my companions made you feel welcome?
It's not exactly the hospitality I'm used to, but your man Isran has seen to my needs well enough. And might I add, this is a remarkable fortress. I have colleagues back home that would love to study this place in detail.
Are you prepared to read the Elder Scroll?
Oh, most certainly. Let's find out what secrets the scroll can tell. If everyone will please be quiet, I must concentrate. I see a vision before me, an image of a great bow. I know this weapon. It is Oriole's bow. Now a voice whispers, saying, "Among the night's children, a dread lord will rise. In an age of strife, when dragons return to the realm of men, darkness will mingle with light, and the night and the day will be as one." The voice fades and the words begin to shimmer and distort. But wait, there is more here. The secret of the bow's power is written elsewhere. I think there is more to the prophecy, recorded in other scrolls. Yes, I see them now. One contains the ancient secrets of the dragons, and the other speaks of the potency of ancient blood. My vision darkens, and I see no more. To know the complete prophecy, we must have the other two scrolls. I must rest now. The reading has made me weary. Come on, old man. You should get some rest.
Completed. Prophet. Started. Chasing Echoes. Speak to Serana. Started. Seeking Disclosure. Find the Elder Scroll. Dragon. Find the Elder Scroll. Blood. Do you have any insights about your Elder Scroll reading?
I wish I could say that I did, but without the other two scrolls, the picture will remain incomplete. I admit, I feel a bit frustrated that I can't be more helpful. Still, our enemy is likely just as much in the dark as we are, and that's something. Now it's a race to claim the remaining scrolls and discover what part Oriole's bow has to play in this prophecy.
Alrighty. So we'll take Prophet off of the quest list. After the Moth Priest's reading, we have more questions than answers. The old priest saw a vision of a weapon called Oriole's Bow, but we need to find two more Elder Scrolls in order to unravel the rest of the prophecy. Alrighty. We can talk to Serana now, and oh yes, let me look at these. Chasing Echoes. Dexian's reading of the Elder Scroll has given rise to more questions than answers. The Moth Priest saw a vision of a weapon called Auriel's Bow, but Serana and I need to locate 2 more Elder Scrolls in order to unravel the rest of the prophecy. Speak to Serana. Seeking disclosure. In order to locate Auriel's Bow, the Moth Priest, Dexian, indicated that 2 other Elder Scrolls would be required. The first scroll foretells the interactions of the dragons with the history of Nirn. The second foreshadows the defiance of the gods with the blood of mortals. Alright. Well, let's speak to Serana first.
Do you have a moment to talk?
What's on your mind?
That Moth Priest, Dexian. He said we needed 2 other Elder Scrolls. I think I know where we can start looking.
Why didn't you say something earlier?
Half the people in your little crew would just as soon kill me as talk to me. That doesn't exactly make me want to open up. I got a warmer welcome from my father, and that's saying something.
Do you trust Harkon at all?
It's not a question of trust. He's just obsessed with the prophecy. And from what I could tell, 1,000 extra years of obsession haven't made him any better. We should have found him a hobby. I don't even think he sees me as his daughter anymore. I'm just a means to an end.
So where is this Elder Scroll?
We need to find my mother, Valerica. She'll definitely know where it is. And if we're lucky, she actually has it herself.
You said you didn't know where she went.
The last time I saw her, she said that she'd go somewhere safe. Somewhere that my father would never search. Other than that, she wouldn't tell me anything. But the way she said it, someplace he would never search. It was cryptic, yet she called attention to it.
Sounds like she was being cautious.
Maybe. What I can't figure out is why she said it that way. Besides, I can't imagine a single place my father would avoid looking. And he's had all this time, too. Any ideas?
In Castle Volkihar?
Wait, that almost makes sense. There's a courtyard in the castle. I used to help her tend a garden there. All of the ingredients for our potions came from there. She used to say that my father couldn't stand the place. Too peaceful.
Isn't that pretty risky, staying around the castle?
Oh, absolutely. But my mother's not a coward. That is, I don't think we'll actually trip over her there, but it's worth a look.
They aren't going to let us use the front door.
But I know a way we can get to the courtyard without arousing suspicion. There's an unused inlet on the northern side of the island that was used by the previous owners to bring supplies into the castle. An old escape tunnel from the castle exits there. I think that's our way in.
Serana, once you say yes, Serana will be with you until you finish the quest. So I am gonna wait a little bit and say, actually, I have some things to do first.
Don't let me stand in your way, then. I'll be at the dock whenever you're ready. I'm ready if you are.
Okay.
I'll be at the dock whenever you're ready.
There she goes. So Serana will meet us at Icewater Jetty, which is fine. Now we can also...
So you think he's just crazy?
I didn't say that. I wondered if perhaps he did it for the attention. But every now and then he'll say something that makes me reconsider.
I suppose we're all a little crazy to be here, right? Do you have a moment? Gunmar and I have been talking and, well, we're slightly worried. We both realized that if Isran's even allowed us in here, he must be really concerned. And if he's that concerned, the situation must be pretty bad. Make sense?
You're worried about what we're up against?
Yes. These vampires are a new threat, and a truly deadly one. Gunmar and I agree that we're going to need Florentius to help. Gunmar and I have a lot of work to do here, so we were hoping that maybe you could track him down.
Who is Florentius?
He's a priest of Arcay. Well, he was. It's complicated. He's a little eccentric, but we can trust him, and we can definitely use his skills.
Where can I find him?
Well, that's the thing. We don't know where he is. Haven't seen him in years. I think he had regular contact with the Vigilance, and I know Isran kept track of them. So maybe you could ask Isran if he knows anything? Just keep in mind that he... well, he might not like the idea.
Started. Bolstering the ranks. Speak with Isran. This is not a Radiant quest, by the way. It's been suggested that the Dawn Guard could use the help of a man named Florentius, a former priest of Arcay. I need to speak with Isran to find out if he knows where Florentius might be.
Cozy little place, isn't it?
Hope you're getting along with Isran. It takes some getting used to.
Alrighty. Isran's upstairs, like usual, so let's go chat with him. Let me check my time. Already verging on half an hour, but that's alright.
I knew it would come to this one day. I knew. And no one believed.
You heard the scroll reading. Now do you believe, Serana?
I heard a lot of vague nonsense. You could interpret that 100 different ways. Only thing that stood out for me was Ariel's bow. That's a powerful weapon, and I sure as oblivion don't want the vampires to get hold of it. The Moth Priest can stay here for now. As for the vampire, I still don't trust it, so keep it on a leash.
I need to find someone named Florentius.
Who said something? Sorin or Gunmar? I thought they'd have learned their lesson by now. I don't trust that man, and I don't want him here.
Sorin thought we'd need his help.
I suppose she's right. I shouldn't let my personal feelings get in the way. Last I heard of him, he was aiding the Vigilance of Stendar at Runvald. He may still be there. If he can maintain some appearance of normalcy, I'll allow him to stay.
Completed. Speak with Isran. Find Florentius.
Keep your eyes open.
I've been asked to find a man named Florentius in the hopes that he can assist the Dawn Guard. I've learned that he was last seen helping the Vigilance of Stendar in Ruinwald. So we will head there now. It's close by here in the Rift. I think at this point, we've got a few new Dawn Guard members. Here's Mogrel.
Now that the Dawn Guard are back, the vampire's reign of terror is about to end. What are you looking at?
He's got some gold, which I'll go ahead and pickpocket. I'll let him keep his bolts, though. I feel like there are a couple of other new members. Other than Florentius, who we still have to do a quest to acquire, the Dawn Guard is now fully staffed. Ingyard, she's new.
I hear you're doing a lot of the work in tracking down these vampires. If there's anything I can do to help, let me know.
How did you join the Dawn Guard?
Something bad happens, word spreads. More bad things happen, people worry. The more they worry, the more they talk about it. I've been hearing rumors for a bit now. I was glad to find out not only the bad rumors were true.
Alrighty.
Now, if you'll excuse me.
We can pick up some Dawn Guard followers, too. Not that I will be using them, but it is a possibility at the moment. Belleval, that's another new one.
Seems that I'm the only one of my kind here. Suppose I shouldn't be surprised. Still, it's my duty to help protect Skyrim as much as any Nords, don't you think?
Why did you join the Dawn Guard?
Isran is the only one trying to do something about these vampires. I don't much like him, but I can't allow the people of Skyrim to be preyed upon by those monsters. I'll be seeing you.
Alrighty. That may be everybody. There may be one more. I can't quite remember. Let's rip through here and see.
Yeah.
Good day. Need something? Sharp. I'd better get going.
Durak is actually a neat follower if you want to grab him in particular. Much like Jazargo, they forgot to program a level cap for him. So he stays awesome. Alright, let's head outside and head to Ruinwald. Another new location that won't, you were able to spot the door if you got right to it, but it won't pop on your compass or become discoverable until this quest is active. There may be another new person out here, too. Let me check on that right quick before I commit to leaving. And again, that may be all. Yeah, Tilda was already here. Vori patrols back and forth. There she is. Okay, nope, I think we're good. So Ruinwald is up here. Closest place is Tolvald's cave. So we'll fast travel there. And see, another new cave, popping on the compass. It's a pretty nice straightforward path up to it from here. Oh, damn. What do we got there? Spider. Oh. I was like, what? Go fuck yourself, frostbite spiders. Alright. Now then. As we were. It's another way up, I guess. I've only done this once, so I don't remember the exact path, but it appears that it's up here. Ah, here we go. Here it is. Dawnguard War Axe, that's interesting. Here's Volk's journal. Let's read it and take it off the book list. Day 14. I knew I should have volunteered for the excavation earlier. For months, Morik had been going on to the Vigilance about detecting mystical energies deep in the East Mountains. Said he'd found some old tomes about the ruins of Ruinwald, or something the like. A Nordic chamber thousands of years old. I remember thinking, yeah, if it's so old, how come no one's found it yet? There's plenty of adventurers wandering around these parts. Seemed like most of the other Vigilants agreed we had more important things to do. But Morik took a team and went digging, and when he started turning up a long-buried temple, well, didn't I feel like a troll in a dung heap? Soon enough, he was sending back letters to the hall, begging for as many men as we could send. I didn't volunteer at first, still seemed like a myth to me. But when word came back that they'd hit the main chamber, I packed up and headed this way to help. Always did want to be a part of history, and better late than never, they say. Well, they didn't mention that the latecomers would be stuck with guard duty. I just sit up here all day, watching for bandits and wolves, neither of which I've seen. Mostly, I just see diggers coming up for supplies. Gotta say, I've been seeing them a lot less regular now that I think about it. Day 19. All right, it's been 3 days since anyone's come up. The last one to emerge was Appa, and he just walked around a bit with a weird, vacant look in his eyes, told Florentius and me to come down as soon as we had the chance, then trudged back in. Something ain't right, and I aims to find out what. Volk. That reminds me, we can ditch the vampire's note from Prophet. And there we have discovered the Ruinwald excavation. We can take it off the location list. I think Ruinwald is also not clearable. Kind of a theme we're developing lately. Anyway, you'll notice there's no real nice, clean path up to here from either side. You just kind of have to bull your way up the mountain one way or the other. And our way worked just fine. So, let's head inside. Note that red haze, we should recognize it from the Prophet quest. Archery increased to 92. It means that that Vigilant was thralled. Charmed Vigilant. 8 ranks of archery to go. This is a neat little dungeon, anyway. Discovering Ruinwald, Volume 1. Take it off the book list and read it. Discovering Ruinwald, Volume 1 by Morik Sidri. I have decided to document our expedition to find Ruinwald in my journals, with hopes that should we fail, it will bring illumination to those who follow us. I myself have stood on the shoulders of academic giants to get where we are today, spending endless hours in libraries and private collections. I am certain that there is some artifact of great power to be found in those ruins, one that the Vigilants could find useful in their mission. I do not mean to sound pompous, but I feel as if I am on the precipice of my destiny with this quest. I am certain we are digging in the right place. I can feel it in my bones, and I dream of finding Ruinwald at night. Even in my waking hours, I can almost hear a reassuring voice telling me we are going the right way. The expedition has had a great deal of luck so far. After only a few weeks, the first tunnel broke through into a large shaft leading downward towards where I suspect to find Ruinwald. With just a few bits of carpentry, we've established our first base camp within the mountains. If we continue to be this fortuitous, we shall reach our goal in record time. M. Sidri. Okay. Check out this room. Apprentice locked chest. Sure, sure. Oh. Take those salt piles. And let's search the two charmed vigilants. There's one. And two. Resist poison is not one of the two I still haven't found. We do have malachite veins in here. I'll mine them out, doesn't take long. And it is a brand new dungeon. So there's that too. did not want the silver necklace. We'll hit this chest. Go ahead and torch that oil slick. Oh, balls. Oh, I don't want to kill the husky. Oh, come on! Oh, it makes me so mad when it does the half shot, even though I drew fully back. It just ticks me off. Oh, I guess dwarven crossbows can drop in random loot now. The 218 base damage is fucking awesome. Of course, that's with my Fortify Archery enchantments factored in, but it's still an unimproved base level crossbow. So that is pretty awesome. Here's another malachite vein. Volume 2 of Discovering Ruin Vault should be close. I can't seem to find the other Charmed Vigilant either. Where'd that other body go? I guess it doesn't really matter. Ah, there it is. Okay, we're good. Here is Discovering Ruin Vault, Volume 2. Take it off the book list and read it. Excuse me. Discovering Ruin Vault, Volume 2 by Morik Sidri. Our luck continues. Not only do we continue to tunnel into caves and shafts that speed our descent, but struck multiple veins of precious ore. Now that the excavation has proven to be a financial success, the Vigilants have sent more supplies, materials, and workers to further the cause. I find myself unable to contain my glee at times, and have become prone to cheerful outbursts in front of the men. One might find this very out of character for me, but the men seem to share my enthusiasm. Never before have I worked with a group so single-minded in their pursuit. To have so many people working towards the same goal, with little to no deviation from the task at hand, is an uncanny blessing. Stendar be praised. With so much going well, I hesitate to document what seem like minor troubles in comparison. It must have something to do with the cramped spaces, but I have found myself prone to aches in my head. While these hardly deter me from my leadership role, I have found myself distracted at times. I have had many a conversation with the workers where I drift off, only to have them call me back to reality. Sometimes I lose small amounts of time and can't remember what I've done. I am hoping this is nothing more than excitement of reaching our goal, but I will try to keep note as we dig deeper. Perhaps a half-tankard of ale before sleep will help me with these headaches. M. Sidri. Onward. Adept locked chest. Well, of course. Oh, goodness. Come on now. I warn you, finding Florentius is the key to There's an angry husky. Finding Florentius first is the key to another chain of Radiant quests, and we will kind of invariably have to repeat some of the ones we've already done just as part of a loop in order to get through to the three Dawnguard artifacts Florentius can send us to. The other thing is we're going to have to go after the Dawnguard caches, which means finding three specific random encounters all over Skyrim. So things are going to get annoyingly randomized for a while once this is done. I apologize for that. It's just the way they program the game. But for now, we're in a nice non-radiant dungeon. We got books. Let's make sure there's nothing new. Not there. Here is Discovering Ruin Vault, Volume 3, which we should read and take off our list. Discovering Ruin Vault, Volume 3, by Morik Sidri. The damnable headaches. Minorn be merciful, I just can't seem to shake them. The workers have started to report them as well, but while their focus on conversation and civility may wane because of it, they have not swayed from their task. If anything, they seem to have doubled their efforts. I myself cannot seem to focus on anything other than the dig. I sit here now, studying some unearthed Nordic artifacts, yet I feel a nagging call to see how the dig is progressing. The other day, without thinking, I picked up a shovel and started digging myself. Fortunately, no one seemed to find this unusual, which is a blessing. I'd hate for the vigilance of Minorn to think that I'd lost my senses. As we dig, we discover more Nordic ruins and architecture, but have yet to hit the main chamber. Every day I dream we'll finally reach Ruinvald, and I can't help but reflect on what this will mean to my reputation. My family will be so proud, especially my father, Minorn. He and mother have always been interested in my studies, even if my sister Minorn was not. But I'm most excited to reveal my findings to my colleagues, Minorn and Minorn, and perhaps my mentor, Minorn. Oh, won't they all be pleased, M. Sidri. Uh-huh. Alrighty. Well, there's a pressure plate in here. And one here. And one there. I can't even spot what they'd actually do if I did... Ah! They'd trigger these crossbows, I suppose. Oh, I don't want the crossbow. That's way too heavy and not worth carrying. Here's another malachite vein. Search all these? I must have. No, I did not. Onward and downward.
What was that?
Oh, balls. Really? He picked that minute, that second to move? Fuck are you going, dude? And you, for that matter. Fuck are you going? Alright, let's make our way down. We'll start here in the obvious side area. (Clears throat) There we go. So these both, well, that platform's just a dead end, so I guess we'll just head down here. That may be everybody. I'm not certain, so I'll keep sneaking for the moment. Ah, it wasn't. See? Good. And I'm pretty sure that's everyone, but I'm actually still not certain. Ah, it's Volk! Remember Volk? It was his journal we found topside. So... I guess we see what happened to him. That's unfortunate. Now here we are at the bottom, and I don't see anyone else. Okay, good. Now, unfortunately, Discovering Ruin Vault Volume 4 can and often does suffer from clipping errors, but it's here, right by the entrance to the main chamber. Either way, it's off the list, either because you never get to read it or because you're able to turn collision off and get hold of it, but I'm taking it off the list, and here it is. Discovering Ruin Vault Volume 4 by Morik Sidri. I have found my muse, and her name is Minorn. Reading back over old journals, I realize she has called to me from deep inside Ruinwald. She is the voice I've been hearing, the one who has called me ever downwards into the mountain. The vigilants, the workers, they hear her too. What joy to learn that I am not alone in her love. Oh, Minorn, how would we have ever found this place without you? As I write this, we are digging out the last bit of rock to get to you. Those without tools have started using their hands. I cannot write anymore. I must get back to work. Ruinwald awaits. M. Sidri. All right. There's that. And apparently, we found the main chamber. So let's head inside. The Ruinwald Temple. Here's another book, simply called Minorn. We'll take that off our book list and read it. The Scripture of Minorn by Morik Sidri. Glory be to Minorn, glory be to the mistress of all, my life for you, O beautiful Savior. Where once my feeble ramblings seemed so grand, I now realize they are but scratches on parchment, unworthy of you. Oh, that I could properly describe you, I would write 1,000 testaments to you. Damn my tiny thoughts, if only I were wiser. Minorn asks that we bring more here for her, more to worship her and do her bidding. I have sent word to the Hall of the Vigilance to come. A simple lie was told, for they would not understand. Not until they saw her, O glorious Minorn. But she is fearful. There are fools in this world that do not heed to her beautiful voice. The guard, Florentius, sent from the beacon, he still prays to Arke, an absentee god who pales in comparison to Minorn. I will pray to the goddess I can see. May he rot in his cage. Oh, sweet, sweet Minorn. Mm-hmm. Yes, well, let's head on down. They're just up there zapping Florentius. Alright, well... The Norn is definitely a bigger problem. And as soon as we kill her, both Charmed Vigilance die as well. So good. She carries the unique Staff of Ruinvald. Oh, and there's Morik Sidri. He didn't deserve to die. None of those Vigilants did. You kind of feel bad for him. Oh well. So it goes. Anyway, that's our way out. And before we leave, let's head up here. Speak to and release Florentius. We can pickpocket him for his 7 gold. Which I'll go ahead and do.
I knew it. I knew Arkay would save me. I asked for help, and he sent you. You are a very welcome addition to this dreary place, my friend. I owe both you and Arkay a great deal. I'm sure I'll manage to repay him later. But you, what can I do to thank you?
You could beat me at Fort Dodgard.
I suppose I could. What, pray tell, is there?
Ysrod needs your help.
Ysrod? My help? Is this some kind of a joke? Did Arkay put you up to this? Ysrod's done nothing but mock me. He's never given me the respect I deserve.
Please, we need your help.
Look, I've just got myself out of quite a mess here, in case you haven't noticed. And while I appreciate your help, I... What's that? No, that's not what I... Yes, but... Sure? Really? Fine. Arkay says it's a good idea for me to go. I don't agree. But he's not the sort of fellow you can just ignore. I'll see you at Fort Dawnguard then. Don't worry. Arkay will show me the way.
Completed. Bolstering the ranks. I've rescued Florentius Banius from Ruinvald, where he was being held captive. He's agreed to return to Fort Dawnguard and aid our cause. So let's take Bolstering the Ranks off the quest list. And let's see about chatting with Florentius. He's got nothing else to say. He will once he gets to Fort Dawnguard. For now, let's just make our way out of here. Got our boss chest here. Nothing that great, just a little gold. You gotta hit that lever in order to open the exit. There's a copy of the Ethereum Wars. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Alright, let's keep on heading out. I believe this will be the exit door that we saw near Tolvald's cave in the first place. Yes, here we go. Let's head to Fort Dawnguard for another chain of radiant quests. Florentius offers 2 different quests. One of them is Lost Relic, which he offers 3 times, which is the way that we get the 3 Dawnguard artifacts. He will also send us on a quest called Rescue, which I only want to do once, but we'll probably have to do more than once. The problem is, we can't only take quests from Florentius. The entire Dawnguard kind of functions as a unit, so we'll have to chain through a few quests from Gunmar and Ysron and Florentius, and just keep doing that until we get all 3 artifacts. But, now that we've completed Bolstering the Ranks, there's a little bit more going on here. Florentius, I presume, stocks the alchemy shelves. So, there we go. Let's see if we can find him. guessing he's going to be asleep in the same room as Serene and Gunmar. Ingyard, Durak. There's Serene. There's Gunmar. Where is Florentius? That is an excellent question. Guess it's possible he's awake.
Divine smile on you, friend.
But if he's awake, maybe he's just not here yet. I'll wait. I bet that's it. Let's wait a few hours.
How is the work coming along?
Fairly well, I'd say. I've managed to get this far without blowing myself up. I still have all my limbs.
What are you doing that's so dangerous?
Nothing. Well, not on purpose. But you never know. The strangest accidents can happen at any time. That's why I always try to be ready for anything.
Sorry for that little hiccup. When you see the dog running down the hall with your wife's dress in his mouth, you, kind of got to drop what you're doing. There's Florentius. He's made it. Good. All right, let's chat with him.
Arke says it's good that we're here, but I don't know. Something about this place doesn't feel right. What? No. Yes, I see. All right. Right. I'll settle in, and then Arke and I will start to put things right. Don't you worry.
Do you know anything about the old Dawnguard?
I've read a few things, heard a few more things. Arke has told me a bit as well. The story they'd like you to believe is that they were such a noble bunch, doing the honorable thing and saving lives. Only I hear that's not quite how it happened. Secret organization, you see. No one to blame when homes are broken into, things stolen. Heard they'd go on midnight raids, pillaging and looting, and then stash the spoils somewhere, guarded by their sigil. Arke tells me the Sunfire spell can break open those caches, but I've never found one. I think you might be lying to me.
What have you got for sale?
Oh, well, some things, I suppose. Remedies, cures, a poison or two.
So he sells Stendar's Aura. For 60 seconds, undead in melee range, take 10 points sun damage per second. And Vampire's Bane, sunlight explosion that does 40 points of damage in a 15-foot radius to undead. So, we'll take those two off the spell list, and much like Sunfire, buying them is the only way to get them. So don't worry about that.
Arke's been watching over me for years now. He says he's not too sure about you yet, though. I once killed 30 vampires with my bare hands, you know. Ask Arke, he'll tell you. Don't you worry about me. I've been through worse. I'll come out of this just fine. It is my sworn duty to see Arke's wrath delivered to all the undead. It's usually a good bit of fun, too. What can I do for you?
What can I do to help?
Speak with Gunmar. He has something for you.
Speak with Gunmar for an assignment.
This is fine for now, but we can't stay holed up here forever.
What can I do to help?
I've located the whereabouts of a vampire masquerading as a common citizen. Track him down and dispose of him. Tread lightly. The law is unaware of the danger. We will treat you as a criminal if you're caught.
What is the vampire doing? Oh yeah, we've done this already.
Glad to be with you.
Just need to figure out which city he's in. Oh, are you fucking kidding me? Ravenrock? No. Uh-uh. Unacceptable. Not gonna do it. I'm not going to let you force me to do the Dragonborn expansion first. That's horseshit.
What? Right. I'll settle in and then I've read a few... The story they... Only I hear that. Heard they'd go on Midnight Red. Arkay tells me the Sunfire spell can break a... Look, I'll be honest with you. I have no idea. But I... Arkay bless you.
Alright. Oh, there's gotta be a way to do this. I hate that they included Solstheim in Radiant Lists. It's like, come on. I don't want to go do the expansion yet. For fuck's sake, game. Anyway. I don't know if this is gonna be good enough or not. We'll find out. I mean, I'm sure I'm gonna have to do an assignment for Gunmar first, but I just hope it isn't that one.
I once killed. Speak with Gunmar. He has something for you.
Do you think Florence?
Cozy little place. I've located. Track him down. Tread lightly. The law. The light be with you.
I'm sure it's Raven Rock. Yep. Alright, well, I tell you what. I'm going to try and figure out a way around this, and in the meantime, we've been going over an hour anyway, so it's a good time to stop. This has been Let's Play Skyrim. We completed Prophet and Bolstering the Ranks, which is pretty good. Now it's trying to force me to do Dragonborn first, which is the exact opposite of what I want to do. We'll find out if I have to give in or not. Until then, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoy my videos, please consider clicking an ad, liking, sharing, or subscribing. As always, these things really help me out. Regardless, please know that I really appreciate the time you spend watching, and hope you have a fantastic day. Bye-bye.